On Hatteberg's people, there are about 1.8 million World War II veterans still alive, but their numbers are dwindling at an awful pace. There will come a time soon when the stories they tell, the memories they have, and the war they experienced will be gone. Retired Pastor Oliver Lindeblad was in Italy as a chief aircraft inspector and flight engineer. Now he lives quietly in Wichita with his daughter Janet Jansen assisting him. His memory of the war, though, is vivid.
And we all had rifles. We each had a rifle at our tent. Adolf Hitler had to be dealt with.
History has recorded who fired the first shot. In the long run, however, all that will matter is who fired the last shot.
I tell you what, every morning, I knew what my job was to do.
We listen to those like Pastor Oliver Lindeblad, who served in World War II, who lived and loved, and to this day tell their stories with pride of someone who knew what they had to do, and like all who served, wondered the same thing.
And that was a thought that went through my head. It might be a one-way trip. And I think probably most of us felt that way.
Now in a tree-lined historic Wichita neighborhood, at 93, his sight is nearly gone, but not his spirit.
I have no aches and no pain anyplace.
He walks daily, even mows his yard, and in his neighborhood,
hi.
Oliver never,
it's so real nice
ever,
to see you.
Same to you, Ollie.
Yeah.
Met a stranger.
You've been my neighbor Valley across the alley.
That's right.
Here's something. It says fire in our tent area.
Oh, yeah.
The memories are still deep and strong as the old scrapbook chronicles his military life.
And that was an auxiliary fuel tank falling down into our area.
In the war years, he and his buddies helped keep those aviators going day after day.
Enemy was over there ready to shoot them down as fast as they came up.
Returning home in 1945, he became a Lutheran minister for 60 years, spending much of his tenure in Hutchinson, where he retired in 1983 and later moved to Wichita.
And there's only three of us in this class that are still living.
But his military memories never far behind, and not long ago went on an honor flight to visit the memorials in Washington, D.C. It was there where people grabbed his hand and thanked him for his service.
It brought tears to my eyes. I was so thankful that they were so thankful for me being in the service.
At 91, Oliver taught himself to play the piano. You see, his life has always been hitting the right note, whether it be in war or peace.